Mr. Speaker, the resolution celebrates the 100th anniversary of the Sons of Italy. But in many ways, it celebrates so much more. I know I would not be here today if my grandfather hadn't come over and decided that he would sell newspapers to make sure that his children could go to college. And on the other side, if my grandfather hadn't said he was going to sell vegetables. So while we celebrate the 100th anniversary of the Sons of Italy, we're also celebrating the dream that so many families, 26 million people in this country of Italian descent, so many families, the dream of having a better life. And Mr. Speaker, I'm going to ask my colleagues here if any of them would also like to give their congratulations to the Sons of Italy.
Gentleman, Mr. Longini, seeking recognition of unanimous consent. Gentleman is in order.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. I would also like to join in the celebration of the 100th anniversary of the Sons of Italy. For many of us, as indicated by the gentleman from Williamsport, my grandfather also came over to this country for the land of opportunity, and he found opportunity in the United States of America. And so we celebrate that as well as celebrating the 100th anniversary of the Sons of Italy. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Gentlemen, Mr. Daly seeking recognition or unanimous consent. Gentlemen is in order.
Thank you for all my Italian supporters in the crowd. My real name is not Daly, it's D'Elia. And my grandfather changed his name. My father was born in Italy, and I'm first generation Italian. And if it wasn't for the opportunity for my grandparents, and I do have a story that Representative Petracca wants me to tell you, but I'm not going to tell you about the meeting with President Franklin Roosevelt today, but at some other time I will. But it's what America's all about. It's what we're all about, what we are all about as a Commonwealth. And I'm so proud of my Italian heritage. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Gentleman from Bucks County, Mr. Santaciro, recognized under unanimous consent.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. As a member of the Sons of Italy, it is indeed a pleasure of mine to be able to stand here with my colleagues. And I want to say it is it's a great country we live in, and a true melting pot, being both Italian and half Irish as well. But I want to make a special note. We talk about our ancestors. My great-grandfather, Richard Mattia, was the first Italian-American freeholder in the state of New Jersey. And as an olive branch to my colleagues on the other side of the aisle, I will tell you, he was a Republican. But he was a progressive one. And I'm proud of that heritage. I'm proud of my Italian heritage. And I want to thank my colleague, Rick Mirabito, for bringing this to the floor. Thank you.